They have more to do with my background in economics, but I think what I'm known for mostly is image work in tourism. Not something I was ever trained to do, but something that I found an opportunity to get involved in, and that's where my name has been made, in image formation. How are images formed? How do you use different types of what we call agents, media, as well as people's personal experiences to form images of destinations? How does that play into the brand of a destination? And then how do you measure a brand, but measure it with respect to sustainable development? Time, his name was John Hunt. And John made his name by beginning this whole process of tourism image research. And one of the first things I was asked to do was to repeat his study. And I said to the funding agency, which was the Utah Travel Council, but I'm an economist, I'm not a psychologist. I said, we don't have any money for economics work. We have money for image work. I said, I'm an image person. And from that point on, I started to do image research. And it pretty much culminated in the 1990s with a published paper on the image formation process, when I looked at the different ways images can be formed and the types of media and how they affect the formation of image. So that work was completed, at least in my mind, in the 1990s. It's never really gone away, but then this whole concept of branding emerged, and image became just a part of branding. And then I took on the task of looking at how destinations can brand themselves. This has all culminated in a recent article where I've actually been able to merge economics with some of the image work and talking about brand equity, which image is one component of, and sustainable development, and merge these two concepts together, which have gone on parallel tracks. So I think that's how my work has evolved, from one focused more on psychology, what people think of places, to one where we can look at destinations, how they present themselves, and also how they value their brand with respect to the economics, as well as impacts on the social cultural system and on the environmental system. Go full circle from psychology back to economics, including psychological measurement and economic measurement. We can't simply go on talking about destination branding without talking about the other aspects of destination impacts. And I mean the environmental impacts, social cultural impacts. Because branding as a concept is primarily used as a business economic concept, but it ignores what tourists bring to an area outside of the money. So I think in the future we have to take a more holistic view of these things and look at the detraction, if there is a detraction from the environmental side or from the social cultural side, some negative impacts, they have to be analyzed with respect to the economic gain to determine whether or not we've achieved what I call sustainable development.